Unprecedented. Prince Crown Prince meets Netanyahu, quotes the Bible, extols Sarah's the great future Sarah's Accords. Did you ever imagine a major Iranian political leader coming to visit Israel, not to threaten the Jewish people with genocide, but to offer his hand of peace, cooperation and mutual respect? It may sound like fiction, like one of my novels, but it's actually happening this week. In an historic development, Iranian Crown Prince Reza Pahlavi, the son of Iran's late king, Shah Mohammad Reza Pahlavi, arrived at Ben-Gurion International Airport yesterday, accompanied by his wife, Yasmine. We are very happy to be here and are dedicated to working toward the peaceful and prosperous future that the people of our region deserve. From the children of Sarras to the children of Israel, we will build this future together in friendship.
Declared a historic visit, the Iranian Crown Prince Reza Pahlavi spends his third day in Israel. He already visited Yad Vashem, Israel's Holocaust Memorial, the Western Wall, met with the Israeli President and Prime Minister. And his mission is to present a different perspective on the Iranian people and to showcase that the current regime, the Islamic Republic, does not represent the Iranians that once had great relations with Israel. Now, Gilad Gamliel, the Israeli intelligence minister who invited or who initiated the visit of Reza Pahlavi, emphasized to them Iran and the connections, the good connections with the Iranian people.
That I have had an opportunity, not just as of myself, but on their behalf, to spread the message of how, contrary to this regime, they have no antagonism to any nation or anything, but quite the contrary. They see a vision where, and specific to Israel, the biblical relationship that Persians have had since the time of Cyrus the Great. From the time when I was at the Waning Wall, the remnants of what Cyrus the Great contributed in rebuilding the temples is still there for all to see. It's a testimony of how valuable and how durable this relationship should be. And what we see today is the exception and not the norm. And I know that Iranians and Israelis see how important it will be for our future to be our strategic partners, to work together to address many issues. So first and foremost, I've come here to convey this message to Israeli citizens, like right after our session here today. And I think this will be a very, very important element that will give the Iranian people a sense that there are so many ways that our work together with our Israeli counterpart could be impactful in a positive way to whatever we need to address in Iran's future.
This is huge. I see American flag. I see different foreign country flags at the White House, around the area, surrounding much joy, but this is not joy, because it's the day of the Lord. For he has spoken it, he has wrote the word, what was to come in the latter end. Palestinians, Iran, I see the flags, they're waving in the on a pole. Congratulations, shaking hands. Multiple people before the White House. I don't know at the White House, but that's what he's showing me. He's showing me parts about the White House, how this is set up on the day of the Lord. There will be multiple people, leaders, things of this sort. I don't know if coalitions, governors, and alliances, sort of these people, in the people in the crowds. Lots of people. This is a huge gathering. The day, darkened day, at the gloomy day of the Lord. Trump is on a stage bringing forth the final announcement. Multiple people, the biggest gathering of this nation has ever witnessed. This is why many people are going to be astonished at him for this surprise announcement. Is the very appointed day of the Lord. When it comes to the biblical timeline of Father, that's what I'm telling you in Holy Spirit right now. It is amongst us right now. The appointed time is this small, you all, this smaller period we have. If you can see my hand, it's this tiny where you can touch skin to skin. That's how close we are. I told you, remember the other week or 2 weeks ago that he was at the knob of the door? Mm-hmm. Okay, the door's fixing to turn and open. Because it's time. I see white, black, green, red flag around Washington. They're waving in the air. I don't know how to explain it to you. They're on the middle poles. Many countries, huge celebration, world peace announced to United States of America. Oh, Jesus. I see the black cars. You know those cars that are government? I don't know why you show me. I see all the black cars. There's many, many big money people coming. Big people with money. Leaders. Maybe even some of the people that are part of the Abraham Accords, they're not telling us. They tell you there's one, there's multiples coming. That's why the celebration is at the White House. I don't know if they're going to announce the announcement at the White House or at the place that Trump loves so much, the Capitol. I don't know, but God is showing me the White House in the midst of the White House without the gates. He doesn't even have the gates. I see the pretty grass. I see the flags. Do you remember the last time the Abraham Accords? Okay, y'all remember that. There's a picture. And there's flags. I believe there's some flags on the White House, correct? Was it American flags, the Babylonian flags? And y'all, yes. It might happen at the White House if he's showing me this. I can't be for certain. I cannot be for certain. Okay, I don't know. Why is he showing me the White House? He's showing me the door. I'm seeing the foreign countries, and these foreign countries is Daniel 5:28. Palestinians and Iran. They have shaken hands. Yeah, the deal is sealed. I just received it.
You were mentioning that one flag, my first thought was Iran.
Yeah, the green, red, black, and white. Whatever one that is, I think that's the Palestinians. Am I correct or wrong?
I believe so. That was the first thing that came to my mind.
What they're doing right now?